Good morning, my brothers and sisters, coming to you from Bellingham, Washington. God has blessed us with a night away, and how appreciative we are for that. Our word of encouragement today comes from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, beginning at verse 9. Now about your love for one another, we do not need to write to you, for you yourselves have been taught by God to love each other. And in fact, you do love all of God's family throughout Macedonia. Yet we urge you, brothers and sisters, to do more and more, and to make it your ambition to lead a quiet life. You should mind your own business and work with your hands, just as we told you, so that your daily life may win the respect of outsiders, and so you will not be dependent on anybody. You know, I really like the part of those verses where it says, so that your daily life may win the respect of outsiders. Too often in our world today, people are trying to impress, people are trying to do what it takes to win people over by the power, prestige that they have. And yet God instructs us just to simply to be ourselves, to serve him in such a way that others respect. The truth is there's all kinds of people rallying to get other people's attention. There's self-help gurus and books and all these things that people want to pull your attention away and want to tell you that's how you should live. We're not out here trying to tell people that they have to know Jesus. We want them to know Jesus, certainly, and we want to share Jesus with them as best we can. But the reality is that they're not going to accept our Jesus unless they can see it in our daily lives. So we need to live and work and play in such a way that respects who God is and that honors God, so that people go, hey, I want something different. I want to be different. I want to know God. I want people to look at my life and whether they see the good times or whether they see times of adversity, say, he loves Jesus. There's something different about him. And I think we all want that. I want to make a difference in this world for the next. I want God to use my life. And to do that, I have to live a life worthy of God as best I can. Now, I can tell you that I'm not perfect. If you're looking for a perfect pastor, you've got the wrong guy. But I'm doing what God has called me to do. And that's the perfection enough. That's what we all need to do. Simply be obedient to what God has called us. God is continually every day to transform me to be more and more like Christ. And I hope that my life shows that, not because of who I am or what I do, but simply because of the obedience to God that I want to give. Let God do the work. I don't have to do it myself. Praise God for that. So I want to encourage you today to just go about what God has planned for you. Be obedient as you can to him and allow people to see God working in your lives. We don't have to shove it down their throats. We simply let them know by our daily tasks who we are. I also want to encourage you that as you come in contact with new people today, whether it's at the grocery store or the bank or at work or wherever you may be, I hope that you'll love on people as Jesus loved us. Isn't it great that we serve a God who loved us first? And then we get to choose him. Let's try to love on people today. Let's just smile at people. Let's just give them the benefit of the doubt. We don't know what they're going through, and we even shouldn't know. But we do know is that they need Jesus. And whether they know him or not now, we can be a blessing to them if we simply open up our hearts. So again, be encouraged today that as you go about this day, that God wants to use you to bless people. Let's do that today. Father God, thank you for this day. Thank you for the opportunity we're going to have to bless people. Father, I just pray right now as we go about our day that you would open our eyes, that we might see people as you see them, that we might simply love them as you would have us to love them, that we might be obedient to your spirit speaking in our hearts. Father, we want to love people in such a way that they see Jesus in all that we do and that they see their need for him. Father, I just pray today that you would bless those who need a special blessing, whether it's a physical healing, a mental healing, an emotional healing, even a spiritual healing, whatever the case could be. We place them in your hands and we ask, Lord, that your will would be done, and done in such a way that you are glorified. Father, we're grateful for this special day as we think of Memorial Day and those who died for our freedom. Father, would you bless each family today that is still suffering that loss that happened maybe recently or so long ago. Father, thank you for their service to our country. Father, we just are grateful for all that you're about to do this day and each day this week. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, there you have it. God loves you. I hope that you'll use this day to not only remember those who have followed, but to celebrate who God is in our life today. Have a great day. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.